Facial recognition technology and artificial intelligence may seem like something bringing us into the future, but they're still battling problems from the past. The problems occur in everything from smart cars that don't start and soap dispensers that don't recognize some hands to even more critical issues like airport security and medical records.
These errors are often based on the color of the user's skin. That's where Dr. Ellis Monk comes in. The Harvard sociologist has come up with a scale that is revolutionizing the way computers work for all of us. It's called the Monk Skin Tone Scale, and it's now being used by Google. Dr. Monk is with us this morning. Dr. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
Yes, thanks for having me. Good morning.
I think a lot of people might be surprised that so many tech devices and so much technology is not utilizing some type of a scale in this way. Talk about the implications.
Absolutely. So as the intro clearly suggested, there's a lot of technology out here that uses different forms of computer vision. Anything that uses some kind of a sensor, like a hand sanitizer, like the air dryers you see in a bathroom, self-driving cars. And if this technology does not use a scale, was not built with the intention to work well across the entire skin tone continuum, then we'll have a lot of problems with these technologies not working well for everyone in the society.
Was it an innocent oversight, or was technology just not advanced enough? What's the culprit here?
Well, I don't necessarily want to call everything innocent, but certainly I think oversight is the way to think about it, because we have to think about who was in the room when some of these forms of technology were designed, right? And unfortunately, for most of the history in Silicon Valley, those rooms haven't necessarily been that diverse, right? So when these forms of technology are designed and when they're tested, some of these forms of technology were not really designed and tested to work well for everyone in the society.
And talk about, we hinted on a couple of the specific things, like an auto sensor soap dispenser might not work on darker color skin because of the way light is reflected. I mean, there's security issues, cell phone cameras auto flash. Talk about how that works.
Absolutely. So if we think about something like a cell phone camera, all these things are using computer vision technology where you have light that's being reflected off of different surfaces. And one of those surfaces, our face, our hands. And when you have darker skin, you have melanin, and that changes how the light is absorbed and reflected by these different forms of technology. So if the technology isn't actually tested to work well when it's reflecting light and absorbing light off of all different types of skin with different levels of melanin, different types of skin pigmentation, then you have these issues.
When one of these big tech companies finds out about this problem, are they horrified? Are they embarrassed? Have they communicated that they are going to start including more people of color in their organizations?
So I think there's been increasing discussions around, increasing diversity across Silicon Valley. One thing to highlight here is that Google really took a huge step with this project. So I've just been really pleased to see a company of the magnitude and the stature of Google take this project on. And because we've open sourced this Monk Skin Tone Scale, we've really lowered the bar for everyone across the tech industry to adopt this scale and to make sure that their products are working equally well for everyone.
So you came up with this tone scale where there's 10 colors in it, whereas before there were only four? And were they even utilizing four different tone colors?
Right. So one of the earlier scales in the industry that most of the tech companies, when they use a scale, they would use this, is called the Fitzpatrick scale. And originally that only had four points on it. And about a decade after that was originally developed, actually by a Harvard dermatologist, they added two more points to the scale. But one thing to highlight about the Fitzpatrick scale is that it actually wasn't designed to classify different skin tones. It was actually about trying to figure out UV treatment for people who have things like psoriasis and eczema and thinking about things like suntan. So it wasn't really designed for this use case in mind. The Monk Skin Tone Scale was specifically designed for the classification of skin tones.
So will this be implemented quickly? I mean, if you use a airport bathroom, if you go through security, do you see this switching pretty quickly?
Well, I think it could because we open source the scale. So.
Yeah.
that really lowers the bar for entry for other companies that are making these different types of devices to go back, try to adopt this scale and to test their products across these different 10 points. One thing that I've already seen is several companies have reached out beyond Google that are interested in adopting the scale. And one company that does stuff in artificial intelligence and what they call synthetic data, where they're creating simulated models, they've already adopted the scale when they're creating these synthetic models in artificial intelligence. So I do think that over time, there will be more and more momentum towards adopting the scale.
All right, Dr. Monk, we appreciate you joining us this morning. Thank you. For more information, visit skintone.google. Thank you, doctor.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.